On this James the Bike Guy, we're going bold in a comfortable fashion with the 2021 Trek Verve 1. This is Trek's entry-level version of their all-out comfort machine, the Verve. So we're going to go into some of the features and designs of this comfort hybrid, talk about where it falls in the lineup of Trek's hybrid series, go over the specs, and then finally, we'll find out exactly what it weighs. So if this kind of thing is interesting to you, I encourage you to sit back, relax, check out this comfort hybrid with me, and let's go ahead and get into it. So the Trek Verve series comes in three models. This happens to be the Verve 1, which is the most entry-level version. The Verve 2 adds on to this just a little bit, and then the Verve 3 is kind of your fully loaded Cadillac version. But here we're getting the same comfortable frame as what you get on the Verve 2 and the Verve 3 as well. And looking at it, you can see just how that works out. So the saddle itself is a little bit lower than the handlebars. You can see the handlebars have some adjustment to make sure that it stays nice and upright. And then you've got these large 700 by 45C tires. So the 700 by 45C tires mean that you end up with road bike diameter wheels, but a nice thick tire to be able to absorb some bumps and vibrations, things like that as you go through. And that's going to be something that's kind of interesting when you compare this to some of the other comfort hybrids. You'll notice there's no suspension on the front end. And in fact, this is running a high tensile steel fork matched up with their aluminum frame, and it's rigid. So you'd think, man, that doesn't make much sense. But what Trek has discovered is with the position of a comfort hybrid like this, you're sitting so far back that in the front end, the suspension really isn't doing much. So they added the wider tires that we were just talking about, made it rigid, and were able to save several pounds in the overall weight. And when we weigh this, you'll notice for an entry-level comfort bike, this is going to be a fair bit lighter than a lot of the other versions. The other neat thing that that allows them to do is you can get it set up with fenders on the front end. It does have mounts. You could do like a pizza rack up front if you wanted to. And then it's going up through this threaded headset to a standard steel quill stem. So the quill stem will have a small amount of adjustment up and down, but this is a place where the Verve 2, it actually has an adjustable stem with a bolt right there that you could adjust. So not quite as capable of adjustment, but still an upright position. And then you go to this M-style handlebar, which is gonna put you in a nice position where your hands, when they're down on the handlebar, you're not in that real straight locked position. It kind of opened up for real comfort. Going to the back, you've got the Bontrager Boulevard saddle, which is pretty cushy. You've got lots of cushion on this, nice smooth top that's water resistant. And then the seat post is gonna be a rigid 27-2 seat post. So this is another place, Verve 2, you would get a shock on the seat post. That's of course something aftermarket you could upgrade, but that is gonna be one of the differences with going to the Verve 2. The frame is that aluminum frame that we talked about. This is their Alpha Gold aluminum, featuring things like internal cable routing, which means you've got a nice clean setup. The top bar is pretty free and clear, so it'll mount up on a car rack really easy. And I'm not sure if you can see it on camera, but this one, which happens to be an orange, just has a gorgeous metallic flake on it. Going to the back, there are brazon bosses to be able to run racks. So you could run a rear rack on the bike. You've also got fender mounts. And one thing that I really like is they've got a rear wheel lock mount as well. So underneath there, you can actually mount up a lock. Avis makes some, a few other brands do, to lock the rear wheel. So if you're out just on a bike path and you want to run in for a coffee, you could flip a switch, it'll lock the rear wheel so somebody couldn't roll away with your bike. While not full high security, it's going to keep it secure enough for those couple of minutes. Drivetrain wise, this has a Shimano Altis and Tourney drivetrain. The spec is fairly nice for the price point, running this Altis rear derailleur. You then have a 7-speed freewheel in the back that has a pretty nice click to it as you freewheel through. And then up front, you've got the Shimano Tourney front derailleur operating this 3x crankset. So that's gonna bring in just about enough gear range to go up just about any climb you'd want to. Now, descending down the climb is of course important too, and for that, we've got mechanical disc brakes. So on the front and the rear, it's got mechanical Tektro brakes. They're operated on the handlebar with the integrated shift and brake lever. And those mechanical brakes are gonna be pretty low maintenance and have a lot more stopping power compared to the brakes that you might have originally seen where they clamp around the wheel. So down there, it's mechanical, quick releases front and rear, and the disc brakes mean you don't have to disconnect the brake or anything like that to pull the wheel off. So it actually makes things a little bit easier. From those quick releases, you'll see the Bontrager connection wheels. These are a 32 spoke wheel, which is gonna give a nice sturdy setup to be able to house the Bontrager H5 comp tires. Now these tires we talked earlier are 45 millimeters wide. The H5 has this almost smooth but still textured tread pattern, which is going to give a pretty high grip on surfaces from anything like gravel, pavement, even very light dirt. This will do pretty well too. Now those shifters we were talking about, index finger is going to bring you to harder gear, thumb brings you to an easier. You'll see that indicated on this screen, and on the left side it'll be reversed but still indicated. So you've got one, which is kind of your climbing gear, you've got two, which is for flat, and then three for either getting a ton of work in or that descent. So now that we've taken a look at some of the features of this Trek Verv 1, I think it's time we find out what this bike comes in and weighs. So the actual weight of this Trek Verv 2 is gonna come in and weigh 31.22 pounds. Well, thanks so much for watching this video on the 2021 Trek Verv 1. Go ahead and let me know your thoughts on this bike down in the comment section below. Personally, I think it's a pretty good looker. Looking at this series, the Verv 1, 2, and 3 are all worth taking a look at. And so I'd love to see exactly what you think. So go ahead, leave those comments down below. Don't forget to hit subscribe, and can't wait to see you out on the next video.